Hello friends, in last lecture we have discussed about the processes, that is constant volume process, constant pressure process, isothermal process, and in this lecture we are going to discuss isentropic process, that is reversible adiabatic process, right? So in the isentropic process, the heat is neither received nor given. It is adiabatic, reversible adiabatic process. Adiabatic means adiabatic wall means the wall from which neither heat comes or nor heat goes outside the wall. So in this, Q is equals to zero always. Also, the entropy during the process remains constant. So delta S also zero, right? Then we have dq is equals to du plus pdv. This is value by the first law of thermodynamics, dq is du, but dq is equals to 0 and du is equals to cv dt, right? So cv dt plus pdv is equals to 0 by the isentropic process. But we have PV is equals to RT. So PDV plus VDP is equals to RDT. Taking differentiation of this equation, above equation. So DT is equals to, right, dt is equals to pdv plus vdp divided by r. So put this value in this equation. Suppose this is equation number 1, right? Then cv into bracket pdv plus vdp divided by r is equals to plus PDV is equals to 0. Then taking cross multiplication and solving above equation, we'll get CV into bracket PDV plus VDP plus P into bracket CP minus CV dv is equals to 0. Here cp minus cv is the value of r, right? Taking common r, then cv pdv plus cv vdp plus cp pdv minus cv pdv is equals to 0. Then in this cv, taking common or dividing both side by PV and CV, right? PV and CV will get CP by CV dV by V plus dP by P is equals to 0. But CP by CV is equals to gamma. So, and taking integration of equation 1, right? CP by, what is equation 1? CV dT plus PdV is equals to 0. Taking integration of equation 1, the above equation, right? Then equation becomes gamma log E V plus log E means natural log, I can write directly as this log C, right? Where C is constant. So PV raised to gamma is equals to constant. This is the law, isentropic law or reversible adiabatic. This means P1 V1 raised to gamma is equals to P2 V2 raised to gamma, so on is equals to constant. Right? In this we have to find out the work done. Right? Applying first law of thermodynamics, Q is equals to delta U plus W, where W is equals to minus delta U, which is equals to U1 minus U2. Right? Work done in this process, we can find out by this internal energy, taking subtraction of internal energy. But W is equals to integration PdV, which is equals to integration C dV by V raised to gamma dash 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 PV raised to gamma is equals to constant by this law. So W is equals to C raised to V raised to minus gamma plus 1 divided by minus gamma plus 1 bracket close, taking integration. Right? Then simplifying the above equation, W is equals to C into bracket V2 raised to minus gamma plus 1 minus V1 raised to minus gamma plus 1 divided by minus gamma plus 1. Because here are 1 to 2 process, 1 to 2. Right? This is 1 to 2, this is 1 to 2. Okay. Right, okay, then W is equals to this value. By simplifying this equation is equals to, I'll write value of C, because P V raised to gamma is equals to C. So by multiplying in the bracket, so I'll write here P2 V2 raised to gamma into V2 raised to minus gamma plus 1 minus P1 V1 raised to gamma V1 raised to minus gamma plus 1 divided by minus gamma plus 1. Right? Here this will get cancelled. So P2 V2 minus P1 V1 raised to minus gamma plus 1. Right? We can write as P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by 1 gamma minus 1. W is equals to, right? Or W is equals to, put P1 V1, PV is equals to MRT. So I'll write here, so equation becomes MR common T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. This is also work done in the isentropy process. And change in entropy, delta S is equals to 0. That is, we have already discussed in the starting of this equation. Here we have to, while solving the problem, we have to consider the relation between PV and T in isentropic process. Right? We have PV raised to gamma is equals to constant. That means P1 V1 raised to gamma is equals to P2 V2 raised to gamma. Right? Then P1 V1 divided by T1 is equals to P2 V2 divided by T2 by the gas laws. Right? This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. We have the ideal gas law. Right? Then from 1 and 2, we can write as P2 P1 is equals to V1 by V2 raised to gamma, which equals to V1 T2 divided by T1 V2. Then T2 divided by T1 V1 divided by V2 raised to gamma minus 1, you can write as, and from above equation we can also write as V1 by V2 is equals to P2 by P1 raised to 1 by gamma into T2 by T1 raised to 1 by gamma minus 1. So P2 is equals to P2 by P1 is equals to T2 by T1 gamma upon gamma minus 1. These are the relations of this P, V and T for these processes. Next process is polytropic process. In this process, polytropic process, discuss after, later after here, I'll repeat the relations here. Relation is important for the solving of numericals. So PV raised to gamma, that means from this equation we have to put the values equal P2 by P1 is equals to P2 by P1 from this equation number 1 is equals to V1 by V2 raised to gamma. And here P2 by P1 is equals to V1 T2 divided by T1 T2. T2 by T1 is equals to V1 by V2 gamma minus 1. Then from this equation P2 and this equation V1 by V2 is equals to 1 by gamma minus P2 by P1, right? From again by equating these equations, by putting the value of these, so this become P2 by P1 is equals to T2 by T1 gamma upon gamma minus 1. These are the values of P2 by P1 in the form of T and V, right? Thank you. If you have any doubt, so you can call me and we'll discuss the doubt. Thank you.